Welcome back to TAGATA PASIFIKA, Nisa Mbulivinaka. Well, when it comes to talking about sexual health with our young people, it's often the case that we don't talk about it at all.
That's right. It's becoming a real concern for sexual health workers who say there's an increasing and disproportionate number of young Pacific people presenting with sexually transmitted infections. Johnson Raela has this story.
So in your own words, you'd explain to me, you know, whether it be just for a routine screen for a sexual health check or if there's something that you're worried about.
Sexual health nurse Dalveen Stephen has seen it all.
So basically what I do is I feel on the side of your groin, so I'm checking your nodes, and that just gives me an indication if there's an infection going on.
She's part of the front line in the fight against sexually transmitted infections.
Then I check your testes, I check your skin, and then I just make sure there's no urethral discharge.
There's a long list of STIs to watch out for, and Pacific people are just as vulnerable.
What's most common in young people, so 18 to 30, is chlamydia and gonorrhea. So with us Pacific Islanders, we have a disproportionate number of people with those infections.
These numbers also reflect worrying signs for Pasifika secondary school students. Recent results from the Youth 12 National Health and Wellbeing Surveys has health professionals concerned.
There's been a reduction in young people using condoms and also contraception. So Pacific young people compared to Palangi young people are half as likely to use condoms and contraception, and that's really concerning.
There are also significant barriers facing young people when it comes to sexual health care.
I think it's got lots to do about the shame, the stigma, and because of all of that it makes people, you know, embarrassed to come.
The Village Collective, an organisation that specialises in Pasifika sexual and reproductive health, view culture as a barrier.
I think we don't talk enough about it, and so what happens for us is that when we don't talk about it, we tend to not follow up and try to find out things. And it's better to know what you actually may have or may not have and get that treated, because having an STI and being untreated is quite can lead to complications later on in life.
However, stats show a reduction in young people being sexually active.
So that's a real improvement. We know that young people who are engaged in school and who have good relationships with their families tend to take less sexual risks as well.